have that Nissan further back. Look at the Capri hunting for the wet on the track. Now that suggests to me that the track has started on wet. Shifts and on the downshifts. The Nick Whale Escorts, the yellow and black car in the background, starting to pick up ground as well. Oh, and a spin for our pole man, Paul Bensley, out of second. Sponsor used to see that lots of times arriving on cars for the Formula 3 race and the Macau Touring Car race. And behind the ex-Andy Rouse, Team ICS, Caliber Sierra in second place. Everybody battling for third as the Cologne Capri swap positions. Up to third place now is the Advan Skyline. Fourth place, Rick Wood in the blue Calsonic Nissan. And fifth and sixth are the two Cologne Capris now. Matt Neal in seventh, and he's been caught by... engines built to take on the BMW CSLs in European touring car and German touring car racing. So a very different generation, looking at a Capri from the 70s and Skylines from the 90s, racing nose to tail. And our race leader, Max Goff, is absolutely charging away.
Fastest lap of the race, 220.886.
And again, you wonder now who did start on wet and who did start on slick.
We do know with Paul Bensley who had that
for Nick Wales company, which has been known for a number of years as Silverstone Auctions, and now changed their name to Iconic Auctions. Also have an auction going here at Silverstone. Now then, this is Andy Middlehurst up into second place ahead of Julian Thomas. The car number two, the Advan Taisan Skyline, the red and black colours, has moved up into second place ahead of Julian Thomas, and Rick Wood's gone through for third as well. Julian Thomas losing ground because here comes Vim Kuhl as well, right, with the Cologne Capri looking down the inside of the Caliber Sierra. So still Max Goff who leads, and by 11 and a half seconds, so he's steaming away. Into the mix comes Julian Thomas to hand over to Callum Lockie.
And the leader in as well. We've got Sierra in the mix as well.
Okay, so that race will be a very speedy segment. Moves up the order, in comes the Capri. Vim Kuhl. And the carries on. Now, if you're driving on your own, you just sit around for 3 minutes. Which is what it takes to go from the pit in beacon to the pit out beacon at 60 km. It all adds up to a total time of 80.2 seconds.
Plus another 60 for the
plus those another cars. 60 for those cars as well, yeah. So you're going to lose 2 minutes 20 on that. The race leader. Look how little spray there is as they come down the pit straight. It is drying fast. That's one of the advantages of it being a relatively warm morning so far, is that the rain is being evaporated and driven away by the tyres, and what was streaming wet when they were on their formation lap is now just sort of dampish.
And that is
for the race,
and we know he got 2:19.592, which is a good